Hello everyone, my name is Pooja Kadam and I am working as assistant professor in Vidyavardhini College of Engineering, Basai. Today, I will be showing you how to make a website in wordpress.com. First of all, in the new tab, type wordpress.com. Once you type the wordpress.com, you will get to see this type of site. If you already have an account in WordPress, then you can directly go to login. If you are a new user, then go to get started. Once you go to get started, you need to fill some basic information after which your site would be created. Now since I have already made a site in WordPress, I'll go to directly login. I'll type my email address here. Continue and password. My site and view site. So see, this is the way my website looks. If you go to visit site, you can see the whole website. I'll again go to my site if I want to make any modifications. Okay, so when I went to my site, this left hand side is called as the dashboard to make modifications to my site. Now I can change the theme, I can change these menus, I can change the writings, the posts, everything in my website. So how? I'll show you the step-by-step procedure. First of all, if I want to change the theme of my website, I'll go to themes, which is here. Customize themes. So there are various themes that are available freely. So out of which I'll choose one theme. For example, say this theme. I'll say activate this design. See, you can see my website theme is now changed. So this way I can change the theme of my website. Now if I want to change site identity, that is, suppose I want to add a logo. At present there is no logo present, so I can add logo from clicking on select logo. So it shows me the media library in which there are already some photos. If I want to add a new photo, go to upload files. Go to select files. So I'll add one photo as logo into it. Say VCT logo. And select. Crop the image. Crop image. Done. So there is a logo of my college that is added to my website. I can again remove this logo by clicking on this remove. Then go back to your dashboard. Okay, so now I can change the colors and backgrounds also. You have this option, say colors and background. For example, orange color, so it has changed the background color to orange. Black color or green color. Say if I want to change it grayish, so I selected that color and say publish. And back. So the color, that is the background color of my site, has changed to gray color. Now if I want to change fonts, I can even change them. For example, theme font, you can see here that it has changed. Publish. Always don't forget to click on publish if you want to save any changes. Back. Similarly, if I want to change the header image, for example, you have certain available header images. For example, if I click on this. So the header image is being changed, you can see here. Again, say publish. And close it. My site and view site. So you can see that the header image is also changed. Again, go to customize. I can even add or delete the menus. Menus are these things: home, about me, research. For example, if I go to menus and currently set to header, this is profile to which is set to currently set to the header. So I'll click on it. Home, about me, research are already available. If I want to remove any menu, I can even remove that. Click on that menu and say remove. So you can see now only home and about me are available. If I want to add any menu, go to add item, type for example contact and say add. Add item. So see, you can see here contact is being added to the menu. Go back. So this is the way you can add menus to your website. Now again, if I want to add widgets. Now what are widgets? Click on it. Footer 1, footer 2, footer 3. According to this theme of this website that we have selected, widgets can be shown at the bottom. That is the footer section. For example, footer 1. Add widget. For example, I click on calendar. I want a calendar in my website. You can see the calendar is being added here. I'll give a title, say calendar. And say add widget. And publish. Close it. Now, if I go at the bottom, you can see one of the widget, that is calendar, is added. Under footer 2, you can add one more widget. Under footer 3, you can add one more widget here in the similar way. Okay, this is about customizing my website. Now, these are some of the blocks that I have created in my website. I can edit them, I can change them. Site pages. If I go to site pages, it shows me already available, that is the contact, research and about me. What pages are available inside this contact, research and about me? For example, if I go in about me and edit. So this is what I have written about me. I can edit it. For example, teaching experience, I'll say 4 years. Go to update. It has shown that page updated. So I'll close it. So it is already updated. If I go on about me, you can see I'll change it to 4 years. So it is updated. Similarly, you can update any of the pages inside your menus. Now blog post. which is here. There are certain blocks that I have already added below. Sorry, home page. So you can see certain blocks, my research papers, my experience in faculty development program, my lecture 1 PPT, all these things. Now, how to add these blocks? Now, first, how to edit the blocks, I'll show you. Go to blog post. Whichever block you want to edit it, click on these 3 dots. For example, my first lecture PPT, I want to edit it. So, go to edit. Okay. So, this is my first blog post. For example, in this lecture 1 PPT, I want to add a link. So click and select the word which should appear as a link. For example, lecture 1, environmental engineering 1, I click this. Go to insert or edit link. Then whichever file you want, type the URL of that file. For example, I have my week 1 course journal in my drive. I'll say share. Copy link and I will paste this link. Add link. So you can see the link is added to this words and hence it has turned to blue color. Update. And close. View site. Now in this lecture 1 PPT, now if I go on this link, it will open my week 1 course journal. So this is how you are going to add link to your blog post. Now suppose I want to add a blog post, say week 2 or say welcome. My first website and publish. Close. Now you can see if I scroll down, welcome my first website. So your blog is being added to your website. This is how you can add site pages and blog posts to your websites. This is a simple way how my website is created. I have created one more website, I'll show you. This is one of the websites that I have created with a different theme, where I have added widgets as map, hours info and the calendar and the search option and different blogs, that is my experience in FDP, that is faculty development program, and my lecture 1 PPT and my complete course journal on ICT. These are my blog posts. When I go to home, you can see this whole website. When I go to about me, it will show me the details that I have filled as about me. And when I go to publications, it will show me my publications. Similarly, if I go to contact, it will show me my contact details. If I want to log out, go here and sign out. So thank you so much for watching my video. This is a simple procedure to how to make a website in WordPress. Thank you so much.